محمد صلی علی رسوله الکریم اما بعد فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی وی آر ڈوئنگ جز 13 سورۃ القرآن انگلش وی آر ڈوئنگ سمری وی آر ناٹ ڈوئنگ ایچ اینڈ ایوری آیا سو ٹوڈے وی گونا ڈو فرام سورہ یوسف آیا نمبر 53 We'll complete Surah Yusuf and then we'll start Suratul Ibrahim, inshallah. So here, let's start from ayah number 53. وَمَا أُبَرِّيُ نَفْسِي إِنَّا نَفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةُ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ And I do not acquit myself. So here, and I do not absolve my inner self of blame surely, Man's inner self often incites to evil. So here, man's inner self incites to evil unless my Lord shows mercy. Certain my Lord is most forgiving and very merciful. So here, I do not declare myself to be perfectly innocent. No, after all, I am also a human being. So here, and I have a soul inside, and indeed the soul is a persistent enjoiner of evil. Meaning the soul continuously, always, it does not stop telling people to sin. This is the struggle that each and every human being lives with. So Yusuf al-Islam, if he is saying that inna al-nafsal ammarat bisu, then what is the really of us? Like, you know, when he is saying that, then we have to check ourselves, how our nafs is. And Allahumma inni a'udhubika min sharri nafsi, from the evil of my soul, because many times we know that what the wrong thing is, but what happens? The nafs makes more attractive and easy, and the nafs makes good difficult. So like, for example, these days we know the reward of praying, qiyam. Of praying, like, you know, in Ramadan time, how we do qiyam. For what happens? Despite knowing the reward, we become lazy. Why? Because of our nafs, we carried away with nafs. So we see one hadith regarding that. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a person managed to recite even 10 ayats in the night, means qiyamul layl, then he will get the reward of qintar, means a heaped up treasure. And qintar of reward is better than dunya, the world, and whatever is in it. So here, inna nafsul ammaratu bisu, why is it that we know all of this virtues and we are tested in all of these virtues? We would pass the test every easily, but when it comes to the action, we fall. Why? Because of our nafs. So here, we have to check ourselves. We have to, like, you know, for example, nafs of how we can overcome with it, you know, by doing the hijra, like intangible hijra, from bad to good, from evil to good. So then only we can overcome. There is one more hadith. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best of the believers in Islam is the one from whose tongue and hands other Muslims are safe. Have you heard of this hadith? Means this hadith everybody knows. So we should, like, you know, check ourselves whether other person is safe from our tongue and hands. And there is one more hadith. The best jihad is the one who strives against himself for the sake of Allah. And the best of the immigrants is the best of the muhajirun, is the one who strives against his nafs. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, the strongest one in not the one who wins in a fight, that where there is a fight, he wins over there. No, the strongest one who against himself, against his nafs, ghalaba nafsaha. So here, strongest one is who do ghalaba nafsaha. So we have to overcome with the nafs. And the king said, bring him to me. So I will appoint him exclusively for myself. And when he spoke to him, he said, indeed, you are today established in position and trusted. Falamma kallamahu. And then when Yusuf al-Islam saw the king, trusted him fully, and he also realized the crisis that the country was going to face in the near future. So Yusuf al-Islam offered his services. He said, Yusuf al-Islam said, appoint me over the storehouses of the land. Indeed, I will be knowing a guardian. Inna hafizun alim. So here we see the situation, and he was telling the king like what skill he has. And later on we see, and we establish Yusuf al-Islam in the land to settle there and where he willed. And he settled over there. And further the story moves on, and finally we see in ayah number 61, they said, we will attempt to dissuade his father from keeping him. Notice now who they don't have much respect for, their own father. Their father was not just a prophet, now he was also an old person. But look at how they say, we will attempt to dissuade his father from keeping him. So as if he was not their brother, as if their father was not their own father, they were behaving that way. And later on we see in ayah number 64, he said, should I entrust you with him except under the concern I trust you with his brother before? So you forced me, you billed me into sending Yusuf, like, you know, once it happened, now for the Binyamin, you are forcing me. Like, you know, now he don't trust, but he can't even tell properly, you know, in front of them. فَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْحَافِزِينَ. Allah is the best guardian, and he is saying Allah will guide. So وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, and he is the most merciful of the merciful. And then they want to take Binyamin with them. And when they open their baggage, what happened, you know, Yusuf al-Islam is appointed on the greater service over there. And when they went, all the brothers, Yusuf al-Islam, he recognized. But even though he recognized, he didn't tell them. And he gave, you know, food extra. And also he returned the money when they found it. So in ayah number 65, when they opened their baggage, they found their merchandise returned to them. They said, oh, our father, what more could we desire? This is our merchandise returned to us, and we will obtain supplies for our family and protect our brothers. This is the time going on about those 7 years of famine, you know. And so here, obtain an increase of camel, O Lord, that is an easy measurement. Why they are saying this? Because they were saying, if you send Binyamin with us, we can get one more camel load. So Yaqub al-Islam said, never will I send him with you until you give me a promise by Allah that you will bring him back to me. He said, you know, you have to promise that you're going to bring it back, unless you should be surrounded by enemies. So, and when they had given the promise, he said, Allah over what we say is witness. So he say, you know, witnessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they went. And later on we see, and he said, oh my sons, do not enter from one gate, but enter from different gates, and I cannot avail you against the decree of Allah. Because they were more, like they were 11, so even he was a prophet. So he said not to enter all of them from one door, enter from the different door. So that's how he said. So here also the decision is only for Allah. Alayhi tawakkaltu, and trust upon Allah, rely upon Allah. And later, and when they entered from where their father had ordered them, it did not avail. And when they entered from where their father had ordered them, it did not avail them against Allah at all, except it has need with the soul of Yaqub al-Islam, which he satisfied. Indeed, he was a possessor of knowledge because of what we taught him, but most of the people do not know. Means whatever the knowledge which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Yaqub al-Islam, because he was a prophet too. So even though he was doing tadbir, but what has to happen, it will happen. And they, when they entered upon Yusuf al-Islam, he took his brother to himself and he said, indeed, I am your brother. Yusuf al-Islam revealed his identity to his full brother. But how? Very secretly. So do not despair over what they used to do to me. You know, now don't be, you know, despair, whatever happened, happened. They said, while approaching them, what is it you are missing? They said, we are missing the measure of the king. You know, what happened? He want to his brother to be there, so he misplaced some measuring cup, and unfortunately what Allah plans, that will happen. and he thought something and something else happened. They said, by Allah, you have certainly known that we do not come to cause corruption. Those people, they were saying, no, we are not thieves, we have never done this, you know. What they did, you know, in ayah number 75, their brothers, they said, its recompense is that he is whose bag it is found. He himself will be recompensed. Thus do we recompense the wrongdoer. So he began search with their bags before the bag of his brother, then extracted it from the bag of his brother. Kazalika kidna li Yusufa. Thus did we made this plan for Yusuf. Allah planned that way. Who could not have taken his brother within the region of the king, except that Allah willed. And it was a tadmir from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he stayed. They said, if he steals, a brother of his has stolen before. Now they are blaming Yusuf al-Islam. They are saying, you know, his brother also used to steal. But Yusuf al-Islam kept it with himself. You know, even though he like feel bad, he didn't even reveal to them. He said, you are worse in the position and Allah is most knowing what you describe. So at that moment of time, he controlled himself and he didn't tell anything. Inna nafsal ammarata bisu, indeed the soul is persistent enjoyer of evil. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, lying leads to sin and sinning leads to hell, and man keeps on telling lies until he is returned before Allah as a liar. Because now they were lying. They said, O Aziz, indeed he has a father who is an old man. Now they are telling to king, now our father is very old man. To take one of us in the place of him, indeed we see you a doer of good. Inna naraka minal muhsineen. And now they are asking, now we have to go. Return to your father and say, O our father, indeed your son has stolen and we did not testify except to what we know. And ask the city in which we were and the caravan in which we came. Indeed, we are truthful. Yaqub al-Islam said, rather your souls have enticed you to something, so patience is most fitting. Fasabrun jameel. So here, you know, he was very sad and upset, but he didn't said. He said, I'm going to do sabrun jameel. And here, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a hadith, patience and overlooking the faults of others is Afdalul Iman. Means patience and overlooking the faults of other people is the Afdalul Iman. So here we see in ayah number 84, and he turned away from them and said, O my sorrow over Yusuf, and his eyes became white from the grief, for he was of that suppressor. Like, you know, his father got very upset, he started crying. Because of that cry and grief and sorrow, his eyes became white. And later on, Qalu, they said, by Allah, you will not cease remembering Yusuf until you become fatally ill or become of those who perish. Now the other sons, they are saying, now still you remember Yusuf and you want to affect your health, so on. They were saying that thing, you know, oh my sons, go and find out about Yusuf and his brother and despair not of relief from the Allah. Indeed, no one despairs of the relief from Allah except the disbelieving people. Now, you know, he's saying to the sons, you know, go and find out about not only Yusuf and also his brother. Like, you know, here in the starting we have seen, like, you know, they told to Yaqub al-Islam, like, he's dead. But still, because he is a prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed. And then he knows that he is alive. Because you remember even about the dream. So here there is a hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once asked by a man, O Messenger of Allah, what are the kabair? What are the major sins? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the kabair are shirk with Allah, giving up hope of the relief from Allah. This is also kabair, you know, giving up hope from Allah. And despair from the mercy of Allah. So we shouldn't be despair from the mercy of Allah. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that our Lord laughs at the despair of his slaves and the closeness of its change. You know, if we lose the hope, Allah will laugh. So we should do tawakkul and hope on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, are you indeed Yusuf? He said, I am Yusuf and this is my brother. Now he is giving the introduction. Allah has certainly favored us. Indeed, he who fears Allah and is patient. Innahu man yattaqi wa yasbir fa inna Allaha la yudhi'ul ajra al muhsinin. Allah does not allow to be lost the reward of those who do good. And then later on, you know, they said, by Allah, certainly Allah has preferred you over us, and indeed we have been sinners. Who is saying this? They are saying, wa inna kunna qati'een. Their brother saying, we were doing the qata. He said, no blame will there be upon you today. Allah will forgive you. He is such a big heart, and he is saying, Allah will forgive you. It's the most merciful of those who show mercy. There's a hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he who does not show mercy to the people, Allah does not show mercy to him. And he who does not forgive them, he is not forgiven. And there is one more hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, charity does not in any way decrease wealth, and servants who forgive Allah adds to his respect, and the one who shows humility, Allah elevates him the sight of people. Here we come to the end, like, you know, how the he called parents and the brothers where he was, and finally the time comes for the dream to come true. You remember, like in the starting, he said to Yaqub al-Islam about his dream, and now that dream, it's the time now, dream has to come true. There was certainly in the stories of lesson from the understanding. And here they continued until then the messenger despaired and were certain that they had been denied. They come to them our victory. There was certainly their stories a lesson for those who understanding. Never was the Quran a narration invented, but a confirmation. Quran is just not the tales, you know, it's the confirmation, and was before it and detailed explanation of all the things and guidance of the people who believe. So here he saw the dream and actually it happened here, and you do not ask them for its payment, it is except a reminder to the worlds. And then finally their parent comes and they were all together, and that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Suratul Yusuf. And here Suratul Yusuf ends. We'll start Suratul Raad. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alif Lam Mim Ra. These are the verses of the book, and what has been revealed to you from your Lord is the truth, but most of the people do not believe. It is Allah who erected the heavens without pillars, isn't it? Do you see any pillars to the sky or heaven? No. Then he established himself above the throne. Where is Allah? Throne. And made subject the sun and the moon, each running its course for a specified term. He arranges each matter. He details the signs that you may of meeting your Lord be certain. And here in further we see in ayah number 9, he is the knower of unseen. Alimul ghaybi wa shahadatil kabirul muta'al. The knower of the unseen and the witness, the grand, the exalted. He is the exalted, and remember the highest status, the highest rank and position of Allah. No one is above him. He is muta'al. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the most beloved speech to Allah is when the servant says, Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabaraka asmaka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruka. So this is the most beloved words. And here in ayah number 13, and the thunder exalts Allah with the praise of him. Thunder is exalting Allah, and the angel as well as from the fear of him. The angel, they do tasbih of Allah. How? Out of fear of Allah. So we need us to fear Allah and exalt him and praise him. How? By doing the tasbih. And he sends thunderbolts and strikes there with whom he wills while they dispute about Allah. He is severe in assault. Here we see here in the ayah Raad is mentioned. Raad is thunder in ayah number 13. From hadith we also see that Raad is the name of an angel. An authentic hadith, Silsilatul Ahadith Sahih, we learn that once Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Raad is the angel from among the angels responsible over the clouds. In his hand is a sword or a whip of fire by which it drives the clouds wherever Allah wills, you know. And it also do yusabbi radu bihamdihi, means rad is making tasbih, praising Allah subhanallah ta'ala. So we should also praise subhanallazi, subhanallazi, and you know, we can say that. And here we learn from this that, you know, when they are in khifa, they are in fear, rad, thunderbolt. So we also should do tasbih and to Allah prostrate whoever is with the heavens and earth willingly or by compulsion, and they shadow as well as in the morning and afternoon. So here we see in ayah number 15, everything is doing the, you know, prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when a person prostrate, he prostrate on 7 parts of the body, his face, his hands, his knees and his feet. This is in Muslim. And here later we see in ayah number 20, allazina yufuna bi ahdillahi, those who fulfill the covenant of Allah and do not break the contract. And what they do, wallazina yasiluna ma amarallahi bihi, and those who join that which Allah has ordered to be joined. What relationship? Wayakshawna rabbahum, and also they fear from their Lord. وَيَخَافُونَ سُوءَ الْحِسَابِ, and are afraid of the evil of their account. And here in ayah number 24, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا سَبَرْتُمْ, peace be upon you for what you patiently endured. Jannah is not for free, it is for sabr, and the life is about sabr, and excellent is the final home. Who is saying? Allah is saying their home is excellent. Afaman huwa qaimun, this is he who is maintainer of every soul. Allah, he sees our deed, he sees our records. Anna, like, you know, Allah is knowing what we earn like any other, but like, you know, whatever we are doing, Allah knows. But to Allah they have attributed partners, means they were doing shirk in the ayah number 33. Say, name them, or do you inform him of that which he knows not upon the earth, or what is apparent of speech? Rather, their own plan has been made attractive to those who disbelieve. Because they disbelieve, they are attractive for their own plannings, and they have been averted from the way of Allah because they are not seeking Sirat-e-Mustaqim. So they are averted, and whoever Allah leaves astray, there will be for him no guide. You know, we should seek guidance, and we should always ask for the guidance. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. The example of paradise which the righteous have been promised is that beneath it river flows. How Allah knows, it's something we cannot even imagine. Here in the house Jannah, beneath which river flows, garden beneath which river flows, means its fruits is lasting and tasty, and its shade is never ending. This is the consequences for righteous, and the consequences for the disbelievers is the hellfire. And so what do we see in this ayah? This is ayah number 35. The fruits of Jannah are eternal. Once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was praying salah, and in his salah he was made to see many things. And after that salah he said, I have shown Jannah and I want to have a bunch of fruits from it. I just wanted to reach my hand out and take a bunch of fruit from it. Had I taken it to you, would have eaten it as long as the world remains. Like, you know, it's not going to end. It's like endless, you know. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he also described the fruits of Jannah. And one of the description that he gave, it's going to be seedless. They don't have seeds, meaning the dates will have no seeds or any other fruits, you know. Literally here, when we go and buy seedless food, sometimes, you know, one or two seed we get, isn't it? Here in Suratul Ibrahim, we'll start Suratul Ibrahim, Alif Lam Ra. This is a book which we have revealed to you, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you might bring mankind out of darknesses into light. So the Quran is the enlightened people, and that many darknesses are darknesses of Jahala and darknesses of Shirk. By permission of their Lord, to the path of exalted in might and praiseworthy. And to Allah belong heaven and earth. Whatever is in between, it belongs to Allah. And we certainly send Musa with our signs. Bring out your people from darknesses into light and remind them of the days of Allah. And here we see, وَإِذَا تَنَازَانَ رَبُّكُمْ, and remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, like, you know, La in shakartum, if you are grateful, la azidannakum, I will surely increase you in your favor, meaning I will give you more than you already have. But la in kafartum, but if you deny, inna azaba la shadid, indeed my punishment is severe. So we have to be grateful. We learn from ayah number 7. So always be shakartum, because it's going to increase the nima. But if you do kafartum, la shadidul azab, Allah will punish you severely, and he will gulp it but will hardly be able to swallow it. This is the punishment in hellfire. He will hardly be able to swallow it, like when a person is sick, he's trying to drink medication, like, you know, he can't. That's how it's going to be. And death will come to him from everywhere, but he is not to die, and before him is a massive punishment. Why this thing? Because they were doing denial and they were arrogant because in their denial. Have you not seen that Allah created the heaven and earth in truth? If he wills, he can do away with you and produce a new creation. So here in ayah number 19, we learn that Allah don't need us. He can replace with other creation. We need Allah subhanallah ta'ala. We need Allah's rahmah and mercy. And further in ayah number 23, وَأُدْخِلَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ جَنَّاتٍ, and those who believed and did righteous deed will be admitted to gardens beneath which rivers flow, abiding eternally. They will be there forever and ever by the permission of their Lord, and their greetings there will be salam, peace. So we should also do salam in this world. Make salam, you know, always do salam. Salam is a dua. And here in ayah number 24, Alam tara kaifa daraballahu maslan, have you not considered how Allah presented an example? Kalimatan tayyiba ka shajaratin tayyiba, making a good word like a good tree. Meaning the example of a good word is like that of a good tree. Which tree is this? The date palm tree. And from hadith we learned that the example of a believer is like that of date palm. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Masalul mu'minun, the example of a believer is like that of nakhla. Nakhla is a date palm. You do not take anything from it except that is beneficial. Each and everything of the date palm is beneficial. So mu'min is always beneficial no matter what happens. Even, you know, calamities or climate changes, still it's good. Asluha sabitun, the roots of the tree is firmly fixed and branches are high in the sky. Wa furaha fis samai, in the sky. So here this is a beautiful example, you know, how a mu'min should be like a tayyib. And here in ayah number 28, alam tara ilal lazina baddalu ni'matallahi, have you not considered those who exchange the favor of Allah for disbelief and settle their people in the home of ruin, means darul bura, like, you know, worst place. And here in ayah number 34, atatukum, and he gave you from all that you asked of him. You know, if you should count the favors of Allah, you could never enumerate them. Indeed, mankind is generally most unjust and ungrateful, because after getting the nima, we are not, you know, grateful. Innal insana lazalumun kaffar. Wa is qala Ibrahim rabbi jali haza baladan aminan, and mention when Ibrahim alayhis salam said, oh my Lord, make the city aman, secure, and keep me and my sons away from worshipping idols. This is in ayah number 35. And also we learn in further, like, you know, how he made so much dua, our Lord, I have settled some of my descendants in an uncultivated valley, and they establish salah. Inna salati tanha anil fahshai wal munkar, so make hearts among the people inclined towards them, and provide for them from the fruits, and they might be grateful. So still we see in the Mecca, when we go there, there are so many fruits and so much peace there. Ibrahim alayhi salam made the dua, and now we see the fulfillment of dua after so many years also, still, subhanallah. Rabbi ja'alni muqimus salati wa min zurriyati rabbana wa taqabbal dua. In ayah number 40, my Lord, make me an established Sharaf, prayer. Rabbana wa taqabbal dua, our Lord, accept my supplication. You see, Ibrahim al-Islam, like, you know, again his concern for Salat is coming up. Why? Because the first question on the Day of Judgment will be Salat. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first matter the servant will be questioned about on the Day of Judgment is prayer. If it is good, then all the rest of the action will be good. If it is corrupted, then all his action will be corrupted. But how the Salat is corrupted means you didn't do it on time, or if you did the Salah but you were heedless, you like not with the khushu and not with the proper way. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, command your children to pray when they become 7 years old. From 7 it's necessary, and that is why we see Rabbi Jalni Muqimus Salati wa min Zurriyati. And here then further we see فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَ اللَّهُ. So never think that Allah will fail in His promise to His Messenger. Indeed, Allah is exalted, might and owner of the retribution. Allah can do anything. And here وَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ. And you will see the criminal that day bound together in shackles, because you know they were rejecting on the Day of Judgment. This is in ayah number 49, and their garments of liquid pitch and their face covered by the fire. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, among those in the fire will be some who along with other punishment will be in the fire, ankle deep, others knee deep, other nose deep, some chest deep, and some fully immersed in the fire. So some are partially and some are fully immersed into the fire. Haza balaun linnas. This Quran is the notification for the people. Means for the people who understand. If they may be warned thereby, warned to for eternity. And they may know that He is but one God, one Allah. And those of understanding will remind. Meaning those are the intelligent here. We should be concerned about their akhirah. Like, you know, we should check ourselves. Are we understanding Quran and Sunnah? Are we doing that? So those people who are on understanding is who is doing with the Sha'ur, Quran and Sunnah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.